see.
It won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on.
Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna go on the verse.
Nope.
But we could, so like, I guess I'll just throw up a one. When I do that, we could do just call me when you need a friend.
Or do you want to do the when you need a friend thing?
Yeah, let's try that.
Call me
when you need a friend.
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 Call me.
Yeah, so as we kind of see it.
Yeah, of course.
I see, yeah, the verse in the chorus. Yeah, because it's like, I'm guessing we're going to need it. Good morning and welcome to St. Bernadette Catholic Church. We're so happy that you're here with us on this 27th Sunday in Ordinary Time, and also as we celebrate and encourage all those with breast cancer and all those who have survived breast cancer. Our opening song will be Christ Be Our Light.
Church, yeah.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen.
Good morning, all.
Good morning.
With joy in my heart, I welcome all of us to the presence of the Lord today, the 27th Sunday, ordinary time, year A. And today, most especially, we identify with sisters and mothers, our relations, first those who are fighting. I use that word, fighting, because it's really a great battle, fighting breast cancer. We identify with them, and I will pray that God may give them victory in that battle, give them the strength, the courage to continue and keep fighting. And for those who have survived, we rejoice with you. And we continue that praying that God may give you the health, continuous health in your new status. And for those who lost the battle, we pray for the repose of all of them. You know them. Some are friends, some are co-workers, some are family members. You know all of them. So remember them in your prayers today, while we pray for those who are alive to continue the fight and to live in good health. We pray for those who lost the battle, that God may receive them. We are all sinners, always praying for God's forgiveness. Let us pray now. I confess to Almighty God, to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, the Virgin, all the angels and saints, you, my brothers and sisters, pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Son of the Father, you take away.
God. Glory to God. Glory to God in the highest and on earth. Peace to people, love, goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High. Glory to God, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest and on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who in the abundance of your kindness surpass the merits and the desires of those who entreat you, pour out your mercy upon us, to pardon what conscience dreads, and to give what prayer does not dare to ask. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Let me now sing of my friend's song concerning his vineyard. My friend had a vineyard on a fertile hillside. He spaded it, cleared it of stones, and planted the choicest vines. Within it, he built a watchtower and hewed out a wine press. Then he looked for the crop of grapes, but what it yielded was wild grapes. Now, inhabitants of Jerusalem, people of Judah, judge between me and my vineyard. What more was there for me to do for my vineyard that I had not done? When I looked for the crop of grapes, did it bring forth wild grapes? Now I will let you know what I mean to do with my vineyard. Take away its hedge. Give it to grazing. Break through its walls. Let it be trampled. Yes, I will make it a ruin. It shall not be pruned or hoed, but overgrown with thorns and briars. I will command the clouds not to send rain upon it. The vineyard of the Lord of hosts is the house of Israel, and the people of Judah are his cherished plant. He looked for judgment, but see, bloodshed. For justice, but hark the outcry. The word of the Lord.
The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. A vine from Egypt you transplanted. You drove away the nations and planted it. It put forth its foliage to the sea, its shoots as far as the river. The vineyard of the Lord is Why have you broken down its walls so that every passerby plucks its fruit? The boar from the forest lays its waste, and the beasts of the field feed upon it. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Once again, O Lord of hosts, look down from heaven and see. Take care of this vine and protect what your right hand has planted. The Son of Man, whom yourself made strong, the vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel. Then we will no more withdraw from you. Give us new life, and we will call upon your name. O Lord of hosts, restore us. If your face shine upon us, then we shall be saved. The vineyard of the Lord is the house of Israel.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, have no anxiety at all, but everything by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, making your requests known to God. Then the peace of God that surpasses all understanding will guard your hearts and minds in Christ Jesus. Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is honorable, whatever is just, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is gracious, if there is any excellence, and if there is any worthy of praise, think about these things. Keep on doing what you have learned and received and heard and seen in me. Then the God of peace will be with you. The word of the Lord.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Oh.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the chief priests and the elders of the people, "Hear another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a hedge around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a tower. Then he leased it to tenants and went on a journey. When vintage time drew near, he sent his servants to the tenants to obtain his produce. But the tenants seized the servants, and one they beat, another they killed, and a third they stoned. Again, he sent other servants, more numerous than the first ones, but they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, thinking, 'They will respect my son.' But when the tenants saw the son, they said to one another, 'This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and acquire his inheritance.' They seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and they killed him. What will the owner of that vineyard do to those tenants when he comes?" They answered him, "He will put those wretched men to a wretched death and lease his vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the proper times." Jesus said to them, "Did you never read in the scriptures, 'The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. By the Lord has this been done, and it is wonderful in our eyes.' Therefore, I say to you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that will produce its fruit." The Gospel of the Lord. You may be seated.
While going through the readings of today's Sunday, something that caught my attention, or a statement in the gospel that caught my attention, is where Jesus said, "When the vintage time drew near, when the vintage time drew near." That caught my attention. But then I had to change it to, "The vintage time is now." So that's the theme of our reflection. The vintage time is now. The gospel said, "When the vintage time drew near." But I'm saying that the vintage time is now. You see, the scripture has a way of using many metaphors to address the message of the kingdom of God. And the aim of those metaphors, or these metaphors, is to direct us on the expected lifestyle that we're supposed to have for us to be children of God and prospective inheritors of the kingdom. That is the aim of this metaphor. And today, the metaphor of the vine and the vineyard saturates the readings, especially the first reading taken from Isaiah chapter 5 from verse 1 to 7, and then the gospel taken from Matthew 21 from verse 33 to 43.
Here, the vineyard is used to refer to the house of Israel. The vines designate the Israelites. But then, we are no longer within the confines of Israel. So I want us to bring that home. So let the vineyard be the house of America. I don't want to use the country because that sounds political. Let's use the house of America. And then the vine represents the American Catholics or the American Christians, especially all of us gathered here to worship God and to listen to his word with the intention of imbibing the principles of God's words into our lives and to make meaning out of our lives. So when the gospel says, when the vintage time drew near, it refers to the vine, because vine as a tree or a plant has a season expected of it to bear fruits. So that is why the gospel says when the vintage time drew near. But then when we use that to refer to humans, humans don't have any season for bearing fruit. We can bear fruit in season and out of season. We can bear fruit all the time. Because vines are irrational entities. We are rational entities. So we can bear fruit all the time, in season and out of season. So while the gospel says when the vintage time drew near, for us humans, I will say that the vintage time is now. It's no longer drawing near, it is now. That is why I timed our reflection today. It's now. So I want us to have that at the back of our mind, that the vintage time is now. When you read through the first reading and the second reading, you could agree with me that the landowner, God, wasn't wrong when he came expecting a bumper harvest, a great yield from his vineyard, having put in a lot of investment, as was described in the readings of today. He has put in a lot of investment. But in spite of all these investments, he was disappointed, because what the vine gave him was a wild grape. He was disappointed. Notwithstanding all this investment I've put into this vineyard, look at what I get. Wild grapes. Now the question is, for you and I, we are the vines of God. At this moment, if God should come to us as his vine, what is he gonna get? Wild grapes or sweet grapes that will yield sweet wine? That is the question I want us, as you go home today, reflect on it. As you go to work next week, reflect on it. At this moment, the vintage time is now. As long as we human beings are concerned, if God is to come at this very moment to you, the vine, to me, the vine, what type of grapes is he gonna get? Wild grapes or sweet ones? He has invested a lot in us. He has invested a lot in us. He has given us life. He has given us health. He has given us wealth, even if it's not huge wealth. But at least if you are contented with what you have, you will be happy. Most of the times, what makes us unhappy is the insatiability attached to the human nature. He has given us his son, Jesus Christ, who came and died for us. He has given us the Holy Spirit. We are baptized and that made us children of God. That is a gift from God. An investment. We receive the Holy Communion every day. Every time we come for Mass, whether weekday or Sunday Mass, he feeds us. He has given us the Holy Spirit. He gives us his word day in, day out, as we are listening to it now. And those words are not just ordinary words. They are words that give life. They are words that are always active in us. What is he going to get after all this investment? White grapes or sweet ones? From you, from I, the vines of God. Listen, we are identifying with our sisters and mothers and the ladies today. If you are one of the survivors, listen, God has made you noble. If you're one of the survivors, it's by the grace of God. Because no matter whatever the doctors and the nurses may have done there, listen, there is something going on in the spiritual which they are not seeing. They cure, but God heals. They are giving the medication. They are doing whatever they know they have learned in their degrees or whatever and whatever. But there's something happening in the spiritual. And God is doing that. It's the healing. So if you are a survivor here, this is a great opportunity God has given to you. It's an investment. What are you doing? He is expecting something. And that is the fruit, the good fruit you're to bear. And if you are still struggling and you are battling with it, listen, the courage, the strength, the hope, they are all gifts of God. You don't manufacture them. You don't read them in the school. They are not within your curriculum in the school. There is no faith 101, or strength 101, or hope 101 in any of the curriculum in the universities or colleges in the university in America. They are great gifts from God. Investments. And the opportunities God has given to you. He said, even in this situation, I'm going to bear fruit. If God comes to me as his vine, he's not going to get wild grapes. He's going to get sweet grapes. One of the illusions majority of us live in is when we think that this life is my life. I'm going to do with it whatever I want to do with it. No, it doesn't concern anybody. That is a big fat lie. Who told you that? Do you know when it started? Do you know when this life started? You just grew up and you realize you are alive. When did it start? You don't know. You are a custodian. You are not the owner. God owns it. He created this life. He gave it to you to take care of. And that is why at the end, he's going to ask you, give account of what you did with the gift I gave to you. So don't live in that illusion. I'm not going to live in that illusion. Life belongs to God. You are a custodian. You grew up and you just realized you are alive. Where did it come from? You don't know. I don't know. Another illusion some of us are living in is to think that the vintage time is in the future. It's not in the future. It's now. If you want to bear fruit, or if you're going to bear fruit, you must have to do it now. Do not procrastinate. A French philosopher by name Albert Camus, he says, do not wait for the last judgment. Judgment takes place every day. Do not wait for the last judgment. Judgment takes time every day. Every day you come back from your work or wherever you go to, sit down. Do an examination of conscience. How did you live today? Did you live to the glory of God? Or did you just live carelessly? Because if we continue to wait and think that the vintage time is at the last judgment, listen, if you get to that point and it becomes the situation where your productivity is not commendable, you don't have time to make any amends. But if you do that check now, you have time to make amends. That is why Socrates, the Greek philosopher, will tell you that an unexamined life is not worth living. There must be an examination. So we all who have gathered here today, the message is the vintage time is now. And if you have that desire to change the course of your life and to raise the bar in your productivity rate, listen, Paul has an advice for us. He says, in whatever you do, be truthful, be honorable, be just, be pure, be loving, be gracious. Let whatever you do be praiseworthy, to give God honor and glory, and to give life and happiness and joy to others. And the God of peace, the God of salvation, will be with you and will be with me. My dear brothers and sisters, the vintage time is now. We identify with our sisters, our family friends, our family members, and our mothers who are celebrating today, the survivors, and praying for those who are struggling, and I'm praying for those who have lost the battle, commending them into the hands of God today. And we pray that the grace of Jesus may continue to help us. The vintage time is now. Amen.
May we profess our faith. I believe in one God, God of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, for our salvation, Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of God. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead. In his kingdom we have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church.
I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayer of the faithful. Let us pray for the grace to bear fruit as God expects from us.
As we respond to God's invitation to the banquet, let us raise our prayers to the God of invitation, knowing they will be heard. That Christians everywhere live lives of loving labor to build up God's kingdom. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For an end to the violence that is plaguing our city's streets, to all who suffer because of war and poverty, and for a just solution to the crisis of homelessness in our country. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. That all world leaders make efforts to improve our stewardship of the earth. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all the sick, especially those suffering with breast cancer, and for those who are in need of healing of body, mind, or spirit, that people of goodwill might step forward to meet their needs and ease their suffering. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all who have died in the peace of Christ, especially those that have died of breast cancer, for all who are near death,
and those who will die this day. And for God's kind blessing and tender mercy to be with all those who will die alone. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray especially today for Michael Harris, MD, for whom this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray especially for all of those suffering with breast cancer for who this Mass is being offered. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all the prayers we hold in the silence of our own hearts. For these prayers and those entered into the prayer and petition book, that they may be received and answered by our God. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, extend your healing hands upon your children gathered here, both those suffering from physical illness, especially the breast cancer, and those who are suffering from the sickness of unproductivity. May your grace be enough for us through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. You may be seated. Saint Augustine is credited with saying, "The church is not a museum for saints. It is a hospital for sinners. The king sends his servants into the streets to gather all they found, bad and good alike. We are called to do the same." Please take a few moments to prayerfully consider your offertory gift to God and thanksgiving for the many blessings you have received this week.
Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain, we all have sorrow, but if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me. If I have things you need to borrow, for no one can fill those of your needs that you won't let show. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You just call on me, sister, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. If have to bear that you can't carry. I'm right up the road. I'll share your load if you just call me, lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you carry on, for it won't be long till I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. You're just a call on me, brother, when you need a hand. We all need somebody to lean on. I just might have a problem that you'll understand. We all need somebody to lean on. Call me. Call me.
When you need a friend.
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 Call me. Sometimes in our lives, we all have pain. We all have sorrow. But if we are wise, we know that there's always tomorrow. Lean on me when you're not strong, and I'll be your friend. I'll help you care. I'm gonna need somebody to lean on. Call me
when you need a friend.
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 Call me. How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that he should give his only son to make a wretch his treasure. How great the path of searing loss, the Father turns his face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory. Behold the man upon a cross, my sin upon his shoulders. Ashamed I hear my mocking voice call out among the scoffers. It was my sin that held him there until it was accomplished. His dying breath has brought me life. I know that it is finished.
brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate with dutiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth, he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life, and by ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we are claimed. Fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread,
therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray. And with the blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, who blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, let us offer to one another a sign of Christ's peace.
The Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Been so good to me. Taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, of the Lord. Glorify the Lord with me. Together, let us all praise His name. I called the Lord and He answered me. From all His troubles, He set me free. Taste and see, taste and see the good. Worship the Lord, all you people. You want for nothing if you ask. Taste and see that God is good. In Him we need put all our trust. Taste and see, taste and see. Goodness of the Lord. Oh, oh, taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord, of the Lord. I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall always be on my lips. My soul shall glory in the Lord, for He has been so good to me. Taste and see, taste and see the goodness of the Lord. Worship the Lord, all you people. You want for nothing if you ask. Taste and see that God is good. In Him we need put all our trust. Lord, oh, have the Lord. Still my soul, the Lord is on thy side. Bear patiently the cross of grief or pain. Leave to thy God to
Let us pray. Grant us, Almighty God, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacraments which we have received. so as to be transformed into what we consume through Christ our Lord.
Are there any birthdays? Any birthdays? All right.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday from St. Bernadette. Happy birthday to you.
Amen, amen. Are there any anniversaries? Any anniversaries? Are there any visitors? Any visitors? Amen. Wow, okay. Okay, now, where are you from? Her. Here. Yeah. Los Angeles, okay. You're from Kansas? Connecticut. That's even farther away. It's a lot warmer here, trust me, particularly in the winter. El Paso, all right. L.A. What did she say? Detroit, Michigan. The Wheel City. And? We get everybody? All the way in the back, where are you from?
Oh, you too. Where are you from?
Los Angeles. Los Angeles. Okay. We got people visiting from other parishes. Good for you. Just so you know, there's what, like 7 million? Thank you. There's like 7 million Catholics or something in the whole Los Angeles crisis. So, yeah, it makes sense. We couldn't fit them all here, so, or there.
Welcome. Welcome. Welcome to St. Bernadette's.
We say welcome.
Welcome.
Welcome to St. Bernadette.
We
all are welcome. Amen. Thank you for jumping in there, David. I'd probably skip to the next one. Yep. Okay, today is Worship in Pink Sunday. All parishioners were invited and encouraged to wear pink or a pink article of clothing, such as a scarf or a tie or a stole. And for those suffering with this dreaded disease. The need at this, shall we have them step? All of those that would like to receive a blessing at this time, those of you who are, even if you beat cancer, or if you're suffering with it, or you simply feel a need of blessing of heal, I invite those people to stand and step into the aisle. So anybody that would like a blessing, come on, I know we've got cancer survivors in here, and I know we got cancer sufferers, so don't be shy. Never turn down a blessing, never. So, your blessing could better than
that. Heavenly Father, you are the source of all blessings. You are the source of our healing, both material and spiritual. We beckon on you to release your deal of healing upon these, your daughters and your sons, who are in need of your mercy, in need of your healing, in need that you intervene in their lives. You tell us in Exodus chapter 15, verse 26, that you are the Lord that healed us. Lord, may your name be realized in our lives. We hope in you. Our faith is in you. The strength we have, you give to us. I leave these, your sons and daughters, before your resplendent throne, Father. Release your healing upon them. May they receive your healing in their lives. May their conditions change because you have said so. In Matthew chapter 8, verse 8, the centurion said, Master, say your word, and your servant will be healed. I beckon you, Lord, from your resplendent throne. Say your words of healing upon these your servants, that they may be healed. That name, Jesus, is the name that brings all healing. In Acts chapter 4, verse 12, no salvation comes from any other name except that name, Jesus. Jesus, may your name bring healing upon these your sons and daughters. As they come to your presence today, may they never leave the same. May they go home rejoicing that their healing has been accomplished in your name. We ask this through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. Amen.
And may the blessing of God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you both now and forever.
Amen. Amen. This announcement is so anticlimactic. Christian Service still needs your bags, paper or plastic. Please take advantage of the baskets at each of the doors and leave your bags or your bag contribution there. The baskets will be out for several more weeks, so please bring them. We need them. In preparation for the arrival of Our Lady of Fatima statue, the only visit to California, by the way, of that statue, the Fatima statue has been touring the world for 40 years, and she's coming here. I guess the Bernadette relics weren't enough. So please, we have that's on a, in preparation. Here it is. Monday, October 9th, and continuing through Wednesday, October 18th, you'll be receiving a Zoom invitation through Flocknote. If you would like to join, we're trying something new. We're trying to do a prayer service every day leading up to that on Flocknote, and then it'll come through as a Zoom appointment. So that way, you know, since it's every day, you're not going to have to come in here. You can stay in your own home and participate in the preparatory prayer service. Last reminder, our facilities are once again open. Yesterday alone, the Alpha Sigs were here in the morning. Faith in Blue was here in the afternoon. Today we have coffee and donuts there, followed by a cotillion rehearsal after coffee and donuts. So that's just an example of one day or one weekend. So if you need the hall, please call the office, get it booked early. If you have regular meetings there, regular events there, even if it's something that's coming up like a fish fry at Easter time, please jump in there and make those appointments. Be an informed parishioner, visit our website, stbernadettela.org, our Facebook page, Twitter page, or simply pick up a paper copy of the bulletin. I can't reiterate this enough. We've got Trunk or Treat coming up. Don't forget Trunk or Treat. This is one of the biggest events we do every year. Ash Wednesday's big, but Trunk or Treat, wow. So please grab a flyer on your way out. It's a great evening for everybody. Again, I think that's the junior daughters that do that as well. I don't know what we do without you folks. I mean, right? You like have half of the or more of the events going on. But please check that out. Please also, we talked about the Pretty in Pink today. Check all of this stuff out on our website, stbernadettela.org, our Facebook page, our Twitter page, or simply take a paper copy of the bulletin. We've done our prayer of healing, and coffee and donuts follows immediately in the parish hall. Thank you to all of you that contributed photos to the railing. The people here are people that are in need of prayers, either on this side of the threshold or that side of the threshold. One of them includes my 30-year-old sister, who died of a malignant brain tumor at 30. So please continue to pray for the repose of the soul of those people and for all of those suffering with this terrible disease. And with that, please stand for the final blessing.
Thank you, and have a lovely week ahead.
Thanks, Father.
The Lord be with you. May the Almighty God bless us in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Tell the good news.